Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist. Diseases of the body can affect your eyes more often than you might think, so I'm here to share with you some common medical conditions and how they can affect your eyes. 1 in 10 Americans have diabetes, and there are many ways diabetes can directly or indirectly affect your eyes. Very high blood sugars can result in swelling of the lens inside the eye, which can cause acute vision changes and nearsightedness. This happens because excess sugars in the blood are converted into sorbitol, which can easily enter the eye and penetrate through the natural lens in your eye. This accumulation of sorbitol will result in an influx of water into the lens and subsequent swelling. This acute change in vision will resolve once the blood sugars go back to normal. More commonly, uncontrolled diabetes and excess sugar in your blood will cause damage to small blood vessels, including those in the retina, which is the vascular wallpaper that lines the back of the eye. Damage to these blood vessels will result in swelling and leaking of the vessels, blocked vessels, and eventually the formation of abnormal new vessels, which are leaky and bleed easily. If untreated, these abnormal vessels can form scar tissue, which may result in a retinal detachment, bleeding inside the eye, and permanent vision loss. Diabetes is also frequently associated with earlier onset of cataracts or a dirty lens inside the eye, and 2 times the risk of glaucoma, or death of the optic nerve, which is the nerve that connects your eye to your brain. If you have a diagnosis of diabetes, you need to get regular eye examinations and do your best to control your blood sugars to prevent irreversible blindness. Another common medical condition that can cause problems to the eyes are problems with the thyroid. Most commonly, an overactive thyroid or hyperthyroidism may result in thyroid eye disease, and about 1/4 of those with hyperthyroidism will develop eye disease. This is a condition where the eye muscles, eyelids, glands, and fatty tissues around and behind the eye become inflamed. This can result in bulging eyes or bug eyes that are classic in thyroid eye disease. The eyes become red, swollen, and uncomfortable, and sometimes there is so much swelling and stiffness that the eyes have trouble moving or even closing completely. So double vision, extreme dry eye, and even vision loss can occur with extreme thyroid eye disease. Symptoms typically burn out after 6 to 12 months, and if symptoms are mild, an ophthalmologist can help you with your dry eye symptoms and monitor you. But if there is significant inflammation, you might require treatment with steroids or even surgery to create space behind the eyes, treat double vision, or help protect the eyes. If you have hyperthyroidism, it is a good idea to establish care with an eye doctor who can help you screen, regularly examine, and manage your eye symptoms as they present. Autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis can present in the eyes as well. Any autoimmune condition where your immune system mistakenly attacks your body will put you at increased risk of uveitis, which is inflammation inside the eye that can typically cause eye redness, sensitivity to light, pain, and blurry vision. Many autoimmune conditions, as well as medications used to treat these autoimmune conditions, can affect tear production and the ocular surface and may result in dry eye. If you have an autoimmune disease, it isn't a bad idea to make sure you have an eye doctor who can monitor your eyes. Some of the more common medications like Plaquenil also require regular eye examination and testing in order to screen for medication toxicity. High blood pressure can affect the eyes in a few different ways. When the blood pressure is extremely high, the optic nerves can become swollen due to a buildup of pressure in and around the eyes. This might result in intermittent blurry or double vision, headaches, and even nausea. When the blood pressure has been chronically elevated, there can be damage to the retinal vessels. This is due to vascular wall changes and can result in blood vessel constriction and bleeding in the eye that look like flames that we call flame-shaped hemorrhages. The best treatment will be to lower the blood pressure in order to prevent permanent vision loss and reduce the risk of a heart attack or stroke. If you have had chickenpox as a child, you are at risk of a condition called shingles, which is a rash caused by the same virus that causes chickenpox, but later in life. Varicella zoster virus, or VZV, stays dormant in the body, but can cause a rash at any time. We usually see this in those over 50 years of age or those with a weakened immune system, but shingles can affect anyone. If you have a shingles rash around your eye, especially if you have a rash at the tip of your nose, you are at risk of developing eye complications to any single layer of the eye, from the eyelid to the cornea to the retina. The most common eye infection will occur in the cornea, which is the clear layer in front of the eye, and this typically happens up to 1 month from the onset of the rash and usually consists of viral particles on the front part of the cornea that can look like a really bad dry eye. This infection can affect every layer of the cornea and the eye, so if you have any eye symptoms associated with a recent or a history of a rash, it is important to get an eye exam as soon as possible. Did you know that so many diseases could also affect your eyes? Leave me a comment down below if you have any questions. Please like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you at my next video. Bye!